In Haiti, even the dead can't find peace. At Port-au-Prince's Grand Cemetery, tombs have been plundered, human remains lay scattered, and coffins desecrated. And Francois Duvalier's tomb hasn't been spared. Little now remains of what was once a grand memorial.
Trouble boiled up in Haiti after President Francois Duvalier refused to step down at the end of his term.
But Papadoc Duvalier was the man whose rule pitched Haiti into chaos. Repression, torture, and the disappearance of thousands marked his time in office. Some hoped it would end when he died and made his son Jean-Claude Duvalier president for life. But under Baby Doc, as he became known, little changed. After 15 years in power, he was exiled in 1986, only to return 25 years later, welcomed by many and invited to official events by Haiti's current president, Michel Martelly. Jean-Claude Duvalier's former lawyer says Baby Doc is greatly misunderstood and did much for Haiti.
The people got poor here after Jean-Claude Duvalier. And there is a word, insecurity. We didn't know these words when Jean-Claude Duvalier was in power. Kidnapping. We didn't know nothing about these things.
But like his father, Baby Doc used his personal militia to repress political opponents. Patrick Ellie lived through both regimes and says the Duvaliers ruled through fear.
I lived almost all my youth in terror, you know, to the point where I got home and I was talking to my father and mother in whisper, because Duvalier had an incredible network of spies.
The Duvaliers led Haiti for almost 30 years and at great cost. Tens of thousands were tortured and killed whilst both father and son led lavish lifestyles. But they remain divisive characters. Some mourn their loss, others feel cheated that neither man faced justice, and many more are simply too young to remember either.
Both Duvaliers died free men, and for many victims that's an injustice. Francois Duvalier's grave now lays vandalized and empty, perhaps a fitting epitaph for a man who many say did so much harm. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Port-au-Prince, Haiti.